conversation with Grandview offensive coordinator Pete Sturbick. And Pete, coming off the win over Waldorf, pretty efficient on the offensive side of the football.
Yeah, we're clicking. I think we scored 3 touchdowns in the first 12 plays. You kind of script things out, and we ended up scoring quicker than I even thought we would. So that was good to see.
Greg Charles, a very efficient day, 20 of 23 for 3 touchdowns, no interceptions.
Yep, he was really good. He missed one throw on a post, had a drop on a screen, and threw the other one away. Those were his 3 incompletions. That, you know, 2 of those probably should have been completed. So he did a great job.
And then running the football, Dante and Darrell both with 2 touchdowns apiece.
Yep, we're real balanced there, and they're a great 1-2 punch. I mean, they just couldn't stop us, and kind of kept running some of the same things over and over again, and, you know, no really point to do too much different, I guess, when things are working. So.
And Clarence Ward is starting to involve maybe him in the offense a little bit more, throwing to him?
Yeah, he's a great tight end. He's got great hands. He's gotten better in the run game. You know, so he's pretty versatile, and, you know, we'll move him out to the slot, and you throw bubble screens to him, and there's a lot of things we can do with him. So.
And Taylor Goble had probably his best game as a Viking.
Yeah, he did. He did. He's a pretty good catch and run guy for a bigger receiver. He's kind of deceptive, and he can open up and run pretty well. And you know, it's good to see him. I think he just ended up the official stats. He just barely got over 100 yards, so it was good to see him have a 100-yard day receiving.
Now McKendree comes in this week. What do they pose to you defensively?
They're physical, aggressive. You know, they're not as big up front as they've been, which is a good thing because they've had some big boys in there. But they still run and hit really well, and you know, they got to be about as good of a winless team as there can be. You know, it's deceiving that they haven't won a game. They played good teams, and I don't think they're a bad team by any means.
Going into the bye week, of course, you want to get some momentum into that bye week before the final 3 games of the season.
Yep.
And the end of the season. 2 of the best teams in the league are coming in to end the season.
Yep. Well, we're just trying to concentrate on McKendree for now. I mean,
we
know what's ahead. But we're just trying to, like you said, get into the bye week feeling good about ourselves. And the only way we're going to do that is if we can get a win.
Now, you think you'll be able to, I know you want to do both running and pass the ball, but is there one or the other they may be able to do a little bit better on Saturday?
You know, we've been able to affect the coverages that they give us in the past couple of years. And I think we'll be able to throw the ball again, and we're running the ball really well right now. I plan on being balanced, you know, and as the game goes on, sometimes one or the other presents itself a little bit more. But we have the ability to do both, which is great. So, that's probably not a great answer, but I think we'll be a little of both and kind of find out as the game goes on what we need to do.
All right, Pete, thanks.
But
offensive coordinator Pete Sturbick.